Hi students, welcome back to Advanced English class, Unit 3 Vocabulary. In this unit, we completed how to learn a new word. Today's lesson is synonyms, antonyms, and one word substitutes. You all know what is synonym, antonym, and one word substitutes, but just remembering, recapturing what is synonym, antonym, and one word substitutes here, we shall do it. From this lesson, you will learn how to use opposites, how to use appropriate words, learn one word substitutes. So, here is one activity, that is pre-reading activity. Read the following conversation. Here, mother and daughter speaking each other. First, mother. How was your first day in college? Daughter. Nice. Mother. How are your teachers? Daughter. They are nice. Mother. Did you like lunch I gave you? Daughter. Yeah, ma. It was very nice. Mother, oh God, my ears hurt. Don't you know any other word than nice? Daughter, why ma? Nice is such a nice word. So now, rewrite the conversation replacing the words in italics with the words given below. Compare both and examine which one sounds better and why. So here are delicious, excellent, wonderful, amazing, awesome, tasty. I hope you know the meaning of delicious, excellent, wonderful, amazing, awesome, tasty. Delicious means very tasty. Excellent, wonderful, adbhutamainatvanti. Wonderful, adbhutam, amazing, very nice, adbhutamainatvanti. Awesome, very good, tasty, ruchikaramaina. So now we have to replace and again write. So, how was your first day in college? Daughter. Nice. You can replace nice with excellent. How was your college? Excellent. How are your teachers? Excellent or wonderful? How are your teachers? They are very nice. Instead of nice, we can say they are very excellent. Did you like lunch I gave you? Yeah, ma. It was very delicious. Tasty. You can use any word. Yeah, ma, it's very nice. Oh God, my ears hurt. Don't you know any other word than nice? Why, ma, nice is such a nice word. Nice is such a amazing word or awesome word. Okay. Next. Here. To enrich and enhance one's vocabulary is essential to improve language skills. Two things are there. Enrich and enhance one's vocabulary. So if you want to develop, if you want to increase your vocabulary, it is essential to improve language skills. So language skills improving is very important to develop vocabulary. Increase vocabulary. Vocabulary increase kavalante. Language skills improve. A wide vocabulary strengthens our all-round language skills. Wide, okay? Large vocabulary strengthens our all-round language skills. Learning and using synonyms, antonyms, and one-word substitutes gives more variety to our language speaking and writing. It also improves comprehension. Comprehension is understanding. We can express ourselves more effectively and precisely. Effectively, powerful ga cheptamo. Simple, precisely, simple ga cheptamo. Sootiga, sooti lekunda. First, what is synonym? In your examination point of view, the question comes, in one mark question comes like this. What is synonym? A word or a phrase That means exactly or nearly the same as another word or phrase in the same language is a synonym. Same ade bhashalo daggaraga ledha near exact ga meaning vache veroka padanni synonym anta. Ade language ఒక పదానికి సంబంధించి సేమ్ అదే మీనింగ్ వచ్చేలాగా లేదా దగ్గరగా మీనింగ్ వచ్చేలాగా ఉన్నటువంటి వర్డ్స్ ని సినానిమ్స్ అంటారు. ఎ థెసారస్ ఈజ్ వెరీ యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ లెర్నింగ్ సినానిమ్స్. సో హౌ కెన్ వి లెర్న్ సినానిమ్స్? ద బెస్ట్ వే ఈజ్ ఫాలోయింగ్ ఆర్ రెఫరింగ్ థెసారస్. ఎ థెసారస్ వెరీ యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ లెర్నింగ్ సినానిమ్స్. సో ఇన్ యువర్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూ ఆల్ దట్ టోల్డ్ యూ వాట్ ఈస్ థెసారస్. థెసారస్ ఈజ్ ఏ వన్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డిక్షనరీ. It gives synonyms and antonyms for a particular word. Example, small and little are synonyms. Next, antonyms. An antonym is a word that means the opposite of another word. Okay, word ki opposite. Vyatirekam. Synonyms and antonyms are exactly opposite. So, synonym opposite in the antonym. Antonym opposite in the synonym. Antonyms are also formed by using prefixes. Generally, antonyms are formed with prefix. Ante ekko shatam, oka 50-60% prefix add cheyadam dwara oka word ki prefix add cheyadam dwara antonyms form ayyadi. A dictionary of antonyms is useful to learn antonyms. Example, light and dark are opposite. Mari prefix ani cheppina kada regular opposite. Adding prefix IR, irregular. Next, one word substitutes. One word substitutes are the words that replace a group of words or a full sentence without creating any kind of ambiguity in the meaning. Ambiguity means confusion. Etvanti confusion lekunda, etvanti confusion create cheyakunda, oka full sentence ni gaani ఒక గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ వర్డ్స్ ని కానీ రీప్లేస్ చేసేదే వన్ వర్డ్ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్. వన్ వర్డ్ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ ఆర్ ద వర్డ్స్ దట్ రీప్లేస్ ఏ గ్రూప్ ఆఫ్ వర్డ్స్ ఆర్ ఎ ఫుల్ సెంటెన్స్ వితౌట్ క్రియేటింగ్ ఎనీ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ అంబిగ్విటీ ఇన్ ద మీనింగ్. వన్ వర్డ్ వన్ మార్క్ క్వశ్చన్ వస్తుంది. ఎటువంటి కన్ఫ్యూజన్ లేకుండా ఫుల్ క్లారిటీతోని చెప్పేది ఒక వర్డ్తో changes. A dictionary of one word substitutes is of great help as a source of reference. Fear of high places. We can replace it as acrophobia. Several online dictionaries can be used to learn antonyms, synonyms and one word substitutes. See here, delightful. So delightful synonyms are pleasant, lovely, joyful, enjoyable, beautiful, like that. Okay, next, clever, knowledgeable, brainy, capable, alert, bright, ingenious, like that. Okay, so use a thesaurus and write synonyms for the following words: delighted, ponder, banner, capture, indecisive, famous, gigantic, hold, impossible, exaggerated, like that. So suppose the delighted means happy. Some more you can write using thesaurus. Ponder means thinking, thinker. Banner means poster. Capture means seize. Indecisive means uncertain. Famous means popular. Gigantic means huge. Hold means grasp, seize. Impossible means not possible. Exaggerate means enlarge. Like that. Next, study the given prefixes and the examples. DIS, IL, IM, IN, IR, UN, MIS. These used to create, to make a word opposite. Suppose loyal, adding a DIS, disloyal, legal, IL, illegal, possible, impossible, secure, insecure, regular, irregular, certain, uncertain, understand, misunderstand. So here, form antonyms for the given word using suitable prefixes. Suppose attended, unattended, formal, informal, credible, incredible, relevant, irrelevant, accurate, inaccurate, efficient, inefficient, satisfied, dissatisfied, order, disorder, probable, improbable, legible, illegible, rational, irrational, mature, immature, conscious, unconscious, moral, immoral, necessary, unnecessary, qualified, disqualified, continue, discontinue, visible, invisible, polite, impolite, responsible, irresponsible, manage, dismanage. Is it correct? Dismanage? No, mismanage. Right. Replace the words in italics with appropriate antonyms. Right. Once there was a little bird. It lived in a big and beautiful garden. An old gardener took care of the garden. He picked the dead leaves and kept the garden clean. He loved the garden and made it attractive. The upkeep of the garden was not easy. The gardener refused any help as he was scared that they will destroy the garden. No one praised him, but he was active and worked hard. He was capable. The bird was cunning and wanted to destroy the garden. When it arrived, there were abundant trees in the garden. The bird got excited and roughly pulled at the fruits. The gardener attacked the bird. He wanted to make the bird captive. He scattered some grains and spread a net. The bird realized the danger it was in. So I think you know the meaning. Little means small, beautiful means pretty, handsome, like that. Old means musali, age old, took care of the garden, next dead, clean, attractive. So these words we have to replace with antonyms. Once there was a little bird, little opposite, big. It lived in a big and a small, beautiful means ugly garden. An old gardener means young gardener took care of the garden. He picked up the dead means alive leaves and kept the garden clean, dirty. He loved the garden, he hated the garden. And made it attractive. Attractive opposite? Ugly. The upkeep of the garden was not easy. Easy means difficult. The gardener. Upkeep means maintaining. Maintaining the garden was not easy. The gardener refused means rejected. And that means opposite, accepted. Any help as he was scared. Scared means bhayapadam. Bold, strong, that they will destroy. Destroy means chedagottadam, construct the garden. No one praised. Praise means mechukodam, scold, But he was active, inactive, dull, and worked hard. Hard means kastapada, lazy. Easy. He was capable. Capable at cheyagalaru. Opposite, incompetent. The board was cunning. Cunning means tuckery. Honest, loyal, and wanted to destroy. Destroy means chedagottadam. Restore the garden. When it arrived, arrive means ravadam. Departed. They were abundant. Abundant, unlimited. So abundant means limited. Trees in the garden. The bird got excited. Excited means chala utsahapadindi. Opposite, discouraged, depressed, and like that. And roughly pulled at the fruits. Roughly means motuga. Roughly means smoothly. Opposite. The gardener attacked. Attack means darshayam. Opposite. Attack means saved, defend, like that. Next, he wanted to make the bird captive. Captive means bandhesh. Release. He scattered. Scattered means vedadara. Opposite, gathered some grains and spread in it. The bird realized the danger it was in. Danger means pramadam. Safe. Safety. Like that. So you can replace the words whatever I say. You can write your own, because there are number of synonyms, number of antonyms are there. Whatever relevant, you can use it. I just explained as a model. Okay, next. Next activity. Write synonyms and antonyms for the given words. An example has been done for you. Word stroll. Stroll means synonym walk. Antonym rush, hurry. Next, cry. Cry synonym weep. Opposite, laugh. Victory means win. Opposite, lose. Generous means kind. Opposite, cruel. Sleepy means nidravotu undadam. So drowsy. Inka tired. Like that. Next, antonym. Active. Like that. Next, ask, perhaps, mistake, choose, wide. You do it. Next activity. Read the given conversation and replace the words in italics with the suitable one word substitutes given. Here, bibliophile. Bibliophile. Zoo, fathom, astronomy, connoisseur, pediatrician, veterinarian, zoophile, ephemeral, optimist. These words are there. We have to replace them like one word substitutes. Right. Vidya and Sandhya both are discussing. First, Vidya. Where did you take Balu today? Sandhya. I took him to this place where animals are kept. Vidya. I bet he enjoyed it. He wanted to become an animal doctor when he grows up. Sandhya. True. Though my husband is a children's specialist, Balu is an animal lover. He is also crazy about books. Vidya. My daughter is interested in the study of heavenly bodies. As you know, I am an expert in art. I think these interests might only last for a short time. Sandhya. Let us be hopeful about their future. Vidya. Sure, we cannot understand the future. Okay, right. First, place where animals are kept. Zoo. Zoo is animals. Where animals be kept. Next, I bet he wants to become an animal doctor. Animal doctor means pastoral doctor. Veterinarian. Next, I bet he enjoyed it. He wants to become an animal doctor. Yes, exactly. Animal doctor, veterinarian. Next, Sandhya. True, though my husband is a children's specialist. Children's specialist means pediatrician. Chinna pillala doctor. Balu is an animal lover. Means zoophile. Okay. Next, he is also crazy about books. Bibliophile. అంటే బాగా పుస్తకాల పురుగు అని పుస్తకాలు బాగా చదివాడని బిబ్లియోఫైల్ అని. నెక్స్ట్, మై డాటర్ ఈజ్ ఇంట్రెస్టెడ్ ఇన్ ద స్టడీ ఆఫ్ ది హెవెన్లీ బాడీస్. అంతరిక్షం, సూర్యుడు, చంద్రుడు, నక్షత్రాలు. ఆస్ట్రానమీ. ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఇన్ ఆర్ట్, ఆర్ట్ పెయింటింగ్స్ ఇలాంటి ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఇన్ ఆర్ట్. So, connoisseur, expert in paintings. I think these interests might only last for a short time. Short time. Short time means kontakalam matrame untai. So, ephemeral is a short. Short time. Next, hopeful, be hopeful means optimistic. We cannot understand the future. That means fathom. Fathom two meanings are there. Not understand and the measurement in oceans. Samudra lotulu ilanti vatini kolchevaru fathom. Road length kolche kilometers. అది సముద్రం లోతుల్ని ఫాథమ్స్ తో కొలుస్తారు. రైట్. సో దీస్ కమ్స్, దీస్ ఆల్ ఈజ్ వన్ వర్డ్ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్స్. జనరలీ దర్ ఈస్ ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ కమింగ్ ఇన్ 5 marks క్వశ్చన్, 3 marks క్వశ్చన్ అండ్ 1 mark క్వశ్చన్స్. అన్ని టైప్ ఆఫ్ అన్ని రకాల క్వశ్చన్స్ లోకి ఇవి వస్తూ ఉంటాయి. వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. ఇవి మాత్రమే కాకుండా యూ కెన్ లెర్న్ సమ్ మోర్ బై రెఫరింగ్ ఆన్లైన్ డిక్షనరీస్ ఆర్ డిక్షనరీస్. Next, match the one word substitutes with their definition. Atheist. Atheist. Atheist means one who doesn't believe in God. Devun Namanvad. Next, ornithologist. Robot 2 cinema. Study of birds. Novice. Ante oka ఏరియాకి ఒక పనికి కొత్తవాడు. సమ్వన్ న్యూ టు హిస్ ప్రొఫెషన్. మిసాంథ్రోప్. ఆంథ్రోప్ మీన్స్ మ్యాన్ కైండ్. మిసాంథ్రోప్ మిస్ మీన్స్ ఆపోజిట్ హేట్ లైక్ దట్ సమ్వన్ హూ హేట్స్ హ్యూమన్స్. నెక్స్ట్ ఇన్డెలిబుల్. డెలీట్. డెలీట్ అంటే తొలగించడం. ఇన్డెలిబుల్ అంటే cannot be removed, something which cannot be removed, like that. Next, assignments. Right, find one word substitutes for the given sentences. Okay. Things which cannot be read. Chadavalenivi. What we call Illegible. We call it illegible. I-L-L-E-G-I-B-L-E. Illegible. One which cannot be seen. Invisible. First one is illegible. Second one, invisible. Right, a person who can speak many languages. Many means poly, polyglot, polylinguist, polyglot. Next, something easily broken, fragile. A great lover of books. Just now we have seen it. Bibliophile. Bibliophile. Study of mankind. Anthropology. Something that can be carried easily. Something that can be carried easily. That means portable. Right. Next, a person who is overly concerned about one's health, just like corona time lo manam bayapadatam. Okay, hypochondriac. Just like hypochondriac. Just a minute. Hypochondriac. Next. One who is present everywhere. Omni means everyone. Omnipresent. Incapable of being corrected. Correct cheyadam kashtam. Incorrigible. Incorrigible. Next, that which can be heard. Audible. Living in water, aquatic. Fear of heights, acrophobia. Killing of large group of people, genocide. Genocide. Sound of elephants, trumpet. Next, a solution or remedy for all diseases. Anni rogalaku sarva roga nivarana. Panacea. Panacea. An examination of dead body to determine the cause of death, postmortem. Postmortem. A news article that reports the recent death of a person. Obituary. Fear of dogs. Cynophobia. A place of enclosed land planted with fruit trees, orchard. So not only these, you can learn from online sources, dictionaries. There are number of one word substitutes are there, like killing of large group of people, genocide, suicide means suicide, killing oneself, killing of uncle side, killing of family side, killing of son or daughter, filicide, killing of brother, fratricide, elderly people, killing of elderly people, geronticide, killing of child, infanticide, killing of husband, matricide, killing of mother, matricide, killing of nephew, nepoticide, killing of men, androcide, like that. There are number of words are there, so you can refer them from online dictionaries. So I hope you understood well. So I request you, please repeat it, listen it once again, complete the activities and assignments in your fair notes, and come to the online class when you can clarify doubts. Okay, with this I am closing the session. Thank you.